All right, let's start by the beginning. So let's start by perhaps taking a look first conceptually at what a Telegram bot is. And first of all, let's even go back a little bit and let's talk about what Telegram is in the first place. Telegram is a messaging app that is designed for cell phones mostly. And if you're familiar with WhatsApp, Telegram is basically has a very similar functionality to WhatsApp. It's just instant messaging with all the other things that you may expect, like stickers, GIFs, exchanging audio, video, and all those kinds of things. I believe Telegram has gotten a lot of popularity very recently. I'm recording this at the beginning of 2021. I believe partially because of the data privacy policies that the owners of WhatsApp have been dealing with lately. So a lot of people are starting to use more and more Telegram as an alternative to WhatsApp. What's very interesting for us is that Telegram has this feature that, well, sorry, let me actually show you what Telegram looks like. So here on my phone, basically, I have Telegram in dark mode, which is basically a chat with contacts and groups, etc., etc., pretty much like WhatsApp or Line or all those other services. And but something that is very interesting about Telegram is that it also has a web client. So you can go to web.telegram.org and you can see that I have like a bunch of contacts. I have a lot of bots that I've been experimenting with recently, some contacts, some groups, etc. But you can type and you can chat with people online, as well as with your app. Okay? And this is great because a lot of what I'm going to be showing is going to be here with the web client, but everything that I'm going to be doing with the web client, you will be able to do exactly the same with your phone. Okay? Now, one of the features that is really interesting about Telegram, as opposed to WhatsApp, for example, which I don't think it has this feature as of this recording, is that Telegram allows you to program bots. And bots are basically services that you can program and that you can connect a back end to so that users can request from the bots, can request things such as information about the weather, they can request things such as stickers, GIFs, that kind of stuff. They can play games with the bots. It's basically an automated service that you can program to interact with users. And it's very nice because it's very streamlined, as in the way you connect to bots is basically adding them as if they were some kind of new user. And then you can basically talk to them in real time. And the way we're going to do that, so what's interesting, Telegram bots have a lot of functionality. They can exchange audio, video, stickers, all that kind of stuff. You are the one who everyone can create Telegram bots for free. It's very simple to do, and this is a lot of what we're going to do in this tutorial series today. And they also have some limitations. So, for example, some limitations are that the advantages are that you can talk to them directly. The advantages are that you can add them to groups and they can listen to what's going on in the group and react and contribute to that conversation. And although some of the limitations are, for example, that bots cannot initiate a conversation with humans, it has to be the human who talks to the bot first, and then the bot can respond to human interaction. I guess this is a limitation that is embedded by design, just to avoid bots like spamming and annoying people. So, which is it's something that it's part of how bots work. And something that is also very interesting is that the way you create bots is by using a bot also in the first place, a bot called the Bot Father, which is like the one to rule them all or something like that. So it's actually very interesting, and we're going to see how to do this in this series of tutorials. The most common way of interacting with a bot is by typing, is by connecting to the robot as to the bot as if it was a user, and then talking to the bot with a series of forward slash commands that you might be able to implement on your backend service. And so that's a little bit of what we're going to do today. And before we do anything else, the next thing that we can do is let's take a look at how to actually create a Telegram bot. So let's take a look at how that works on the next video.